Our Lady of Bethania, 1976 to 1984.
Maria Esperanza is considered to be one of the greatest mystics of our time. Showered with many gifts of God, this 7-year-old woman, as of 1998, has displayed a number of incredible, unexplainable phenomena that defies natural humanistic explanation. She suffers with the piercing signs of stigmata, the bleeding wounds of Christ. Maria Esperanza has the wondrous ability of healing, levitation, biocognition, and the capability of predicting future events. Maria Esperanza was born in the village of San Rafael, Barracas, Montaga State, Venezuela, on November 22, 1928. She had her first mystical experience at the age of 5 with the apparitions of Saint Teresa of the Little Lower, who from the waters of the Orinoco River tossed her a red rose. During her adolescence, Maria Esperanza's health was frail and her heart grew weaker and weaker. Later on, the onset of another illness partially paralyzed her. She was told by 22 physicians she had no hope of life. Then she was healed again after the Sacred Heart of Jesus appeared to her and gave her the first of hundreds of messages.
The Virgin Mary manifests herself under the title Mary, Virgin and Mother, Reconciler of all people and nations. Maria Esperanza has received countless messages from Our Lady. At times she received more than one message per day. Since the beginning, Our Lady has predicted many historic events, wars, and different occurrences which have taken place around the world. Even in such tragic prophecy, Esperanza always delivered her message with hope. As part of his ongoing investigation, Bishop Pio Bello personally interviewed several hundred witnesses and took about 550 written statements, and some of the documents contain more than one signature, to the extent that at least 1,000 people actually signed their names to the document certifying their testimony. During Bishop Pio Bello's investigations, he consulted with the then Cardinal Prefect of the Sacred Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith, Cardinal Joseph Ratzinger, and also John Paul II himself. Bishop Pio Bello's investigation were completed, he waited 3 years for further reflection and discernment. Then he issued a pastoral letter on November 21st, 1987, declaring that the Bethania apparitions not only conform with scripture and church teachings, but also are authentic, they are supernatural, and they are of divine source.
Bishop Pio Bello Ricardo declared Finca Bethania as a sacred place for pilgrimages, prayer, and worship. Although there is no official feast day, Our Lady of Bethania is celebrated with other Marian apparitions. Maria had a vision later on in her life of an old house, a waterfall, and a grotto. Maria and her husband searched for the land for years and finally found it in a land known as Bethania. On March 25th, 1976, Mary appeared to Maria for the first time. Mary appeared to her and other people who were close to her a few more times, usually on March 25th. On March 25th, 1984, the Virgin had appeared to her and 108 people. The message that Our Lady of Bethania brought is one of reconciliation and love. Mary tells Maria to reconcile and forgive to other people. Mary says that reconciliation between people and nations is the only thing that will save us from eternal death and war.
We could be anywhere.
This apparition can be useful to people in the 21st century because we can reflect back to her message of reconciliation and love to help us reconcile with God. The Church has been reluctant to accepting apparitions which are evidence of divine, seem to call for more than simply human faith, even if it does not appear that they demand a truly theological faith. The decision as to the authenticity of a particular apparition comes from sufficient study and solid evidence.